Hello, sir. What are you holding on your hand?
Oh, this is a book about this special Chinese Kung Fu skill known as Liu Mai Shen Jian.
Uh-huh. So what is Liu Mai Shen Jian?
Oh, okay. Yeah. According to the Chinese literature, this hero, okay, he has a very special Kung Fu skill. Okay? When he's not happy with the enemy, what he'll do is that he'll take a finger and then point towards the enemy. And then, doing, energy will come out from the finger and then strike the enemy die. This is a special skill known as Liu Mai Shen Jian.
So wouldn't it be cool if, let's say, we can do something like this in the real life?
Aha! Exactly, okay. In my research, okay, I made use of a focused laser beam to achieve exactly just that. Let me show you. Welcome to the NUS Department of Physics Nanomaterials Lab. Right in front of you here, we have this focused laser beam system, otherwise known as OSCAR.
Why is it called OSCAR?
Aha, okay. All our instruments, we have special nickname. This particular focused laser beam system, we make use of green laser. Hence, we call this OSCAR.
Is there other machine around here?
Yes, we have a wide variety of focused laser beam system. There's one that the laser beam light is blue in color, we call it Smurf. And there's one where the laser beam light is red in color, we call it Wuming.
What is Wuming?
Wuming is, it means no name. Okay, it's actually the name of a Chinese Kung Fu fighter, just for the fun of it.
So sir, can you explain to me how does this machine work?
Okay. So let me explain to you the basic principle of this focused laser beam system.
Okay.
Right over here, essentially, we just have a laser source. So this one emits laser light. In this case, of course, it's green color. Okay. As the laser beam is unblocked, it will come here and then get reflected by a mirror, go up here, reflected by another mirror, and then which reflect the laser light into this optical microscope system. Okay. So over here, this is where the laser beam enter the microscope system. And when it reach here, it will encounter a beam splitter, which essentially reflect part of the light downward towards the objective lens.
I see.
So when the light passes through the objective lens, it will be focused down to a small tiny spot.
So I'd like to ask, what is the objective lens?
Objective lens, if you like, is like a magnifying glass. It's able to change the path of the laser light. In this case, it will squeeze and focus the laser beam light towards a small tiny spot. Okay, Yongwei, okay, let me show you the details of what happens over here. Okay, you see, when the laser light passes through the optical train and reach the objective lens, and if you unblock the laser light, you see, there's a green laser spot over here.
Yeah.
In other words, now the laser beam is being focused onto the nanomaterials. This nanomaterial sits on the computer control stage. Because being nanomaterial is so small, okay, you can't really control it with your bare hand. Okay?
Yes.
A computer control stage will move the sample with respect to a fixed laser speed.
Okay, so sir, what type of scale are we talking about? Is it very small?
It's very small. Typically, the materials that we are investigating is of the realm of a micrometer, micron to nanometer.
So how small is a micron?
Let me explain to you in a simple term. Okay? Mm-hmm. For example, if I pull out a strand of a human hair,
yeah.
Would you agree with me a single strand of a human hair is like a cylindrical rod?
Yeah.
Okay. So now if I point the cross sections of a human hair to you,
I see.
You will see a circle.
Yeah.
Imagine now you have a super duper knife and you do this. Shh. You slice the cross section of human hair one time, you get two pieces.
Yeah.
Now imagine you have a fresh piece of a human hair and you do this. Shh. 99 times.
Yeah.
Then you will get 100 pieces.
Yes.
So imagine you take a 5 pair of fingers of yours, you take out one of the 100 slices that you have just created.
Yes.
And then you take yet another super duper duper knife and then slice the cross section of this one slice. 999 times.
Yes.
You get 1,000 pieces.
Yes.
And if you take out one small tiny piece of that 1,000 slice that you have just created,
yes.
The width of that slice is 1 nanometer.
Okay, so is that the reason why we have to use the computer control stage?
Correct, yeah, because every movement here is very small and tiny step. Our human hand is just too coarse. So computer control using a stepper model like this can give you step resolutions of a few tens of nanometers. So it's much, much better.
It's much more precise.
Much precise. And you can also design different computer programs to make the sample move in a certain pattern. And you can create micro pattern onto the materials that you're investigating.
Okay, sir, I'd like to ask, can you do a demonstration?
Sure, I'll be happy to, okay? First, yeah. I will need samples, okay?
What type of sample are you looking for?
I think the best sample to show you is to use a human hair. Can I cut a strand of your human hair and then put it on as a sample for investigation?
Sure.
Okay, let's go.
Thank you.
So sir, where's my hair?
Your hair sample is now positioned onto the sample stage of the optical microscope. Let me show you what we can do to your hair, okay?
Okay.
So now what I'm going to do is that I'm going to, release the shutter so that the laser light can come in, and you can see now your samples has been illuminated by the laser light, okay?
Yeah.
So we do not use our eyepiece to look at our samples, okay? Typically, we will send the image to the camera, okay? And camera will capture the pictures and then display onto the monitor over here.
Okay,
you see, this is a single strand of your hair, okay? And now you see that laser spot is actually now illuminated over here.
Yeah.
So the computer control stage, is controlled by this particular program, okay?
Yeah.
So if you pay attention to the screen and see what happens when I move your samples, your hair sample, respect to the laser light, okay? Here it goes. 1, 2, 3. Okay, and then I can move left and right, okay?
When the laser shine onto my hair, what happened to my hair?
Why is our hair dark? Okay, why is our hair black? Because our hair is very good at absorbing light. So when the laser light is being focused by the lens onto the hair, the amount of energy focused on the small tiny spot is actually huge. Okay, so and the hair absorbs the laser light effectively. Okay, and so this translates into a high intense temperatures. So essentially, you can create localized control melting of the hair sample. And hence, you create micro pattern as you move your hair with the computer control stage.
Okay, so that means if I can program a pattern, you can do any pattern on my hair?
Absolutely correct. Okay, so we can create rather complicated patterns and then create these micro patterns onto the human hair. But of course, not extremely complicated because then everything will be washed out.
So usually, how long does it take for a machine like this to carve out a pattern?
Depends on the complexity of the pattern, but within a matter of minutes, we can do this. Okay. I can show you how to create an alphabet of NUS onto the human hair. Would you like to see it?
Sure.
Okay, let's do it. Hey Yongwei, over here we have the Wu Ming focused laser beam system. Okay, the main difference, as you can see here, the laser beam is actually red in color. Okay? So the rest of the mirrors and then the beam splitter and the objective lens is very similar to the Oscar system. And over here, of course, our sample sits on the computer control stage. We can create a nice NUS microstructures, and I can show you here on the screen.
Yep.
Okay. Let me show you, demonstrate to you a very simple way to create structures. For example, you can just let the laser light come in, and then all you need to do is to draw a box, and then done.
Yep.
Okay. So this particular type of samples here is a line array of carbon nanotubes.
So what is carbon nanotubes?
It is a kind of nanomaterials that we investigate in our research.
So where do we get all these carbon nanotubes?
So you can grow your carbon nanotube yourself. So we make use of a very specialized technique known as the plasma enhanced chemical vapor depositions, which make use of the carbon radicals and then stitch them together onto some nanoparticle catalyst and form nice tube structures on the surface of the substrate.
So sir, do we make all this material in the university?
Yes. We have a different lab, which is not here. Okay, we call the chemical vapor depositions room, whereby a wide variety of furnaces and chemical vapor deposition system that I can show you next time.
So can you tell me what type of experiment do scientists use or do scientists work with on this machine?
So a focused laser beam is a very useful and versatile tool because essentially what you do is that you focus the energy of laser beam onto your nanomaterial samples. That particular high energy spots allow you to create structures like micro patterning. Alternatively, you can use this as a means to create chemical reactions between the sample as well as the oxygen in the environment.
Yep.
You can even have the sample submerged inside water, so you can generate some kind of chemical reactions with the sample reacting with the reagents inside the water. Or you can house the sample in some kind of controlled environment gaseous chamber, so you can create all kinds of interactions in that way. So you can see that our setup here is essentially very simple and easy to understand and easy to learn and easy to start doing something useful together with this, okay? So in our lab, we have students from junior colleges as well as high school who spend times in our lab carry out perhaps a year-long research project to use a focused laser beam as a main tool to investigate on the effect of a focused laser beam on a wide variety of material system. It can be nano, it can be micro, it can be any system that is of interest. And their curiosity is to find out what happens when the laser light interacts with the sample. And we have discovered a lot of interesting discovery. So Yongwei, I hope that you have learned something interesting today with regards to what we do in the NUS Physics Department Nano Materials Lab. We do have many other research areas and research activities. If you're interested, I'll be very happy to show you some of those activities in the future.
Definitely interested. Let's hope that we have another episode coming soon.
Great.
Okay, bye.
Bye.